Looks like we got a little bit of snow overnight. But that's not what brings me out so early.
We were gone last night and didn't get back until after dark. Even though it wasn't that late, it was dark. And when I went to shut the chickens up, there were two missing.
And one was my new little rooster that I like, and then one of my white leghorn hens. So Steve and I came out and scoured the yard. And it hadn't snowed at that point, so a white hen should stick out pretty clear, but we didn't see her. We found the rooster way down in this bush, so we got him out. He was roosting in there, so we got him and put him away. But there's no sign of the white hen. And we walked all over the yard and looked. This isn't unheard of. Sometimes my chickens will try to roost in a tree or something, but they haven't been doing it for probably a month or so since it got colder. Oh, look what I see. Oh, I'm so excited. Look at that. Oh, I thought for sure she was a goner because she wasn't with that rooster. This was my best hope, was that somehow we'd see her walking around this morning. Yay. We have been so fortunate with predators. I mean, we just really have not had many issues, and one was a neighbor's dog, but I had trouble sleeping last night thinking if she was out somewhere. She was probably freezing because it snowed all night long. She seems okay, doesn't she? Let's go see. A white leghorn is not really equipped for sitting out in the snow. She looks kind of rough, but I don't see injuries or anything. Good luck trying to catch her ever. Here she comes. Let's try to get the poor thing back in. My intention for her and that rooster to be out every day, but they just fly right over the fence. All right, let's try to look her over and make sure she's okay. She looks wet, doesn't she? She's been out in the snow all night long. Seems like a good recipe for frostbite to me. There we go. I think they're going to be staying in the enclosed run today. She's very wet and hungry as usual, but I'm not seeing any blood or anything like that. My original concern was that something got after them, and that's what caused that rooster to be in that bush and not come out and come into the coop at night. And when I couldn't find her anywhere, like up in the trees, we got very concerned. But this is the best case scenario. Actually, the best case scenario would be getting her into a cage in the warmer garage and giving her some good food and drying her off a little, but there's no catching her at this point. She's completely crazy. And it's really not that super cold today, even though it is snowing. There's the good white hens that stay in the coop at night and actually lay eggs in the coop. Come on, girls. I do keep light on. It's not a heat bulb. It's just a low wattage bulb that's on a timer that comes on at 5 in the morning and goes off like 8 in the morning, and then comes back on at 4:30 in the afternoon and goes off at 8 in the evening, to try to keep them around 15 hours of light, which hopefully helps with laying, although it's not right now. All right, guys, well, thanks for coming with me this morning to help me find my hen. I didn't have very high hopes of finding her walking around the yard, so I'm glad we did. Have a nice rest of the weekend. Well, against all odds, I was able to just pick her up there while she was busy eating that corn out in the run. So I brought her inside. These are never easy birds to work with, in my opinion. They're so flighty and crazy. So she just fought with me in the doorway trying to get out and got water all over her, which won't help being wet. But I did dry her off and looked at her, and I don't see any injuries. So I think she's good to go. Just like, you know how you maybe had that grandma that always gave you chicken noodle soup when you sneezed? I always give them scrambled eggs with that diluted NutriDrench. So she has all of her food with some corn and a tomato. So I'm gonna let her sit in here today. And just keep an eye on her.